Continuing from the previous example, now we're going to take a look what happens when the RHS values of the constraints modify. That is, what happens if this 40 or 60, which is on the right hand side of the constraints, change. Suppose that this 60 changes to 130. Now, this is the optimal table. In the optimal table, there is no change right now. What we are going to do is look at something which is called an optimal inverse, because these two S1 and S2 are slack variables. This part or this matrix is called the optimal inverse, because we have the new constraints as 40 and 130. We write this as like, we write 1 minus 1 by 3, 0, 1 by 3, the optimal inverse, which is the 2 cross 2 matrix, and multiply that with the new constraints. After we have obtained the optimal solution, based on these constraints, we take the optimal inverse and multiply it with the column vector containing this 40, which is as it is. We can also change this. If a question asks to change both of them, there's no problem. This method works both ways. We have 40 and 130, which is a 2 cross 1 matrix. So the answer you will get is a 2 cross 1 matrix, which is minus 10 by 3 and 130 by 3. So what happens is, this vector now gets substituted in your new XB values, which was 20 and 20 earlier. We change that, minus 10 by 3, 130 by 3. Okay, so again we have 20, 10, 0, 0. We need to calculate delta J's. But as you can see, this here is negative, which causes infeasibility. And when this kind of thing happens, we need to resort to dual simplex method. We need to calculate the delta J's. The ratio, now we can calculate delta J by R1, first row, because we have the negative XB over here. We get this is 0, no ratio, no ratio, no ratio. Only the negative values in the denominator are taken and the absolute ratios are taken. So the final optimal answer becomes 10 and 40 with the S2 in the basis variable. So what happens is X1 becomes the basis, comes in the basis matrix, and the answer is 40. So this is what happens in a nutshell. We calculate the optimal table, we take a look at the optimal inverse, which is nothing but the columns of the slack variables, and multiply that optimal inverse into the changed column vector and substitute it in the new XBs, then continue optimality or feasibility, whatever the situation arises according to the question.